right into the video. So I've had this device for 4 days now, and I am liking the device so far. It runs nice, it's smooth, very snappy, but of course that's to be expected. This is a iPhone device, and we all know how iOS makes their device just work. Now, I do have a gripe, a little nitpick. I'm being a little petty, just a little bit. I like the device, but look at how big that camera bump is. Not only how big the camera bump is, look at how big those cameras are. That is crazy. I know there's supposed to be better cameras for better photos, better video, but man, these camera bumps really stick out no matter if you put a case on it. These camera bumps still stick out very much. That's one thing that I'm not really digging about the iPhone 13 Pro Max. I'm not saying it's a bad design. I just wish the cameras were not so big and the bump was not so big, because if you like to rock your phone naked, I'm gonna say naked because this is naked, there's no case on it. So if you like to rock your phone naked, that's going to be very hard for you to do, especially when you are placing it down on the table like this, because the cameras are just so protruding so much that the table could damage your phone just by placing it on the table like this. I know a lot of us like to place our phones flat on the table like this, that way we can still see if we have a notification or something, but that's not good to do or recommended with the iPhone 13 Pro Max because of the camera bump. But that was just me being a little petty. Back to the good stuff. Like I said, this is an awesome device. It's an awesome device. No problems with it so far. I know this has only been 4 days, but to me, this is what a first impressions is. The first time you opened it, took it out the box, your first thoughts, your first impressions. Another thing that I do want to say is good for first impressions, man, the battery life. I am loving the battery life on the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Sorry, I almost said the Galaxy, but that's because I have a Galaxy Z Fold. But the battery life on here is lasting me all day. It could maybe even go for 2 or 3 days, but I'm not going to push it that far because I like to charge up. I'm the kind of person that I like when I take my phone off the charger. I run it, I'm using it, I'm opening apps, I'm watching YouTube, I'm checking my notifications, I'm checking Twitter. And by the end of the day, it needs a charge. And I charge my device every time I go to bed. I don't know if that's good or bad, but that's just how I roll. But this iPhone 13 Pro Max battery life is awesome to me. It's real nice. So I can say kudos to Apple for stepping the battery up, because they did put a bigger battery up in here. I'll try to have some information on the battery somewhere in this video. My channel is not really good about specs, so I don't really talk about phone specs. So if you came to find out the specs of the device, you have to go somewhere else. But I will try to post something on the side of the video, or a little pop-up letting you know the specs and the battery and how big the battery is on the iPhone 13 Pro Max. But trust me, this battery is good. When you're paying $1,000-something for a device, that's what you want. Good battery life that's gonna last. And this battery right here lasts. I can say that because I currently have the Z Fold 3. Yes, that is a foldable device, so it has a lot of things going on and running at the same time, especially when you open it up. There's two separate batteries in it running two separate screens. So yes, that's pushing out a lot of battery, but that battery in that device is okay. It's not good. It's not great. It's still good, but it's not great. The battery in the Z Fold 3 could be a lot better. And this iPhone 13 Pro Max, I hate to say, this iPhone 13 Pro Max battery life beats the Z Fold 3 battery life all day, every day. So it's a champ when it comes to the battery life. But overall, nice, sleek, smooth scrolling, no hiccups. I can't really speak on the 20 hertz display only because I'm really not into having a device with 20 hertz. I know it's nice to have, it'll make it even smoother. The 60 hertz display is perfectly fine with me. Yes, my Z Fold 3 has a 128 hertz display. I leave that turned off. I turned it off on my iPhone 13 Pro Max. Of course, when you're running 20 hertz display, it's running up, it's eating up even more battery. But if you leave it on 60 hertz, it will save a little bit more battery. But they say your phone will run a little tad bit slower than it should. I have no problems with it. I've been running it 60 hertz straight out the box, and I'm probably going to keep it that way. I really don't need it to go any faster. It's running smooth for me already. But pretty much, this was just my first impressions of the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Rate, comment, and subscribe to this YouTube tech channel, and I'll catch you in the next video.